Christ, the love of God, and communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
I want to welcome everyone to our Mass as we glorify God and give Him praise. Let's also take a moment to prepare ourselves upon times we have sinned and need God's mercy and forgiveness.
You were sent to heal the contrite of heart. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You were called to save sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You are seated at the right hand of the Father to intercede for us. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Have mercy on us. Forgive us our sins. Bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
God, forever and ever.
Amen.
reading from the book of the prophet Ezekiel. Thus says the Lord, you say, the Lord's way is not fair. Hear now, house of Israel, is it my way that is unfair, or rather, are your ways unfair? When someone virtuous turns away from virtue to commit iniquity and dies, it is because of the iniquity he committed that he must die. But if he turns from his wickedness that he has committed and does what is right and just, he shall preserve his life, since he has turned away from all the sins that he has committed. He surely shall live. He shall not die. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Philippians. Brothers and sisters, if there is any encouragement in Christ, any solace in love, any participation in the Spirit, any compassion and mercy, complete my joy by being of the same mind with the same love, united in heart, thinking one thing. Do nothing out of selfishness or out of vainglory. Rather, humbly regard others as more important than yourselves, each looking out not for his own interests, but also for those of others. Have in you the same attitude that is also in Christ Jesus, who, though he was in the form of God, did not regard equality with God something to be grasped. Rather, he emptied himself, taking the form of a slave, coming in human likeness, and found human in appearance, he humbled himself becoming obedient to the point of death, even death on a cross. Because of this, God greatly exalted him and bestowed on him the name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bend of those in heaven and on earth and under the earth, and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord, to the glory of God the Father. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Collectors and prostitutes are entering the kingdom of God before you. When John came to you in the way of righteousness, you did not believe him, but tax collectors and prostitutes did. Yet even when you saw that, you did not later change your minds and believe him. The gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Father Andrew Geary talked about a parable of two sisters that are babysitters, and a family came into the community, found out about these two sister babysitters, and asked one of them to babysit their two children. And when they came back from their evening, they saw that their two children were still up. They're like gazed eyes. The babysitter was on the couch half asleep. The house was a mess. The parents looked at each other, this is not working. In the morning, kids praised the new babysitter. She had helped them with their homework assignment, actually prayed with them. She didn't make it go to bed early either. But they got home, sure enough, the house is immaculately clean. The kids were already in bed, asleep. The babysitter said they were like angels. In the morning, as the kids got up, said, "Mommy, that babysitter yelled and swore at us. Mommy, she didn't help us with our assignment. Mommy, she was talking to her boyfriend on the phone all the time. Mommy, she went outside when we had to go to bed early. She went outside and we saw her smoke a cigarette. Whoa. I wish the two babysitters would you want." Today in our gospel, Jesus asked the chief priests and the tax collectors, "Which one did the father's will? Which son?"
"For me."
Father asked the older son to go out into the vineyard to work. Or said, in a mood of rebellion, "No way. No way, Dad." Then he regretted what he said and went out and worked really hard. The second son, the dad asked, "Go out to the vineyard." He said, "Well, sure enough, Dad, I'm on my way." He never went. He asked the chief priest, "Which one did the father's will?" You know?
Me.
And he said, "It's way with the tax collectors and the sinners and prostitutes." They believed in John and his way of righteousness, and they said yes. He says, "You guys, not so much. You chief priests, you hypocrites, you Pharisees." So dig at them. We always like that one, dig a little bit. But maybe Jesus is talking to us too. Is our word good? Do we do what we're supposed to do? Do we do what is right? Do we keep our promises as we should? There's a woman who lost her husband at a young age. She had to raise two children all by herself. And she told her pastor at the visitation that all the people said they were going to help her out. Nobody helped her out. It was other people that helped her raise her children. Thank God those people did help, because she needed it. There was a person who writes plays. One of the characters in the play talked about his marriage and his parenthood. He said it wasn't what was all about was his wife promised to him. He didn't marry her for all her faults and weaknesses, He married her for her promise to him. And same with him. He said he had a lot of faults, but he made a promise to her that when they had their children, what protected them and made them grow to wonderful young people, it was not the house, it wasn't the money, it wasn't the love and the care, it was the promise. It was the promise. One of the greatest, if not the greatest, president of all times, Abraham Lincoln. Early on, before he went to politics, Abraham Lincoln and his friend, his reputation precede himself. Because he had a nickname. Does anybody know what that nickname is?
Honest Abe.
Right. Honest Abe. Honest Abe. When we do what's right, it comes back to us in ways we don't ever realize. There's a coach called Cleveland Stroud. True story. 18 years, he's a basketball coach in Rockdale, Georgia. He built that program. It wasn't much program when he first started. He built it up. 18th year, they won the state championship in basketball. And the parents and the players even put the coach on their shoulders as they went out to the gym. He was a hero on the paper. 2 months later, as he's doing the paperwork for the Athletic Association, he found out one of his players was academically ineligible. He didn't play much either, just near the end of the game every so often. And he didn't know what to do. And no one would ever find out about it. He wouldn't hurt anybody, he just kept quiet. But it haunted him, kind of depressed. Like I said, doing the right thing is more important than the trophy. He called up the association, told them the situation. They forfeited all the games that year, took the trophy back. The kids were devastated in the locker room as he tried to tell them, it's important to do the right thing, always be honest. You know, you've got to follow the rule. And then he said something. You may at some point forget the score of the game, but people will never forget what you're made of. You never forget what you're made of. We need to be promise keepers. Do the right thing. There's a person, he's a gospel writer, but he wrote a book. His name is Bill Gaither, and his wife Gloria told about his life. He's from a small town in Indiana, Alexandria, Indiana. And in the book, he's telling about when they first got married. They both had jobs of teaching in that small community. Didn't make much money, but they wanted to settle there and make a family. They wanted to keep the roots there. The young people were leaving, going to Indianapolis. They wanted to make a statement. So they saw some land in the southern part, and they find out that the owner was a banker who just retired. He had a lot of land all over. And he was 92 years old. He would go into his office still. He's retired, but he'd go in his office for an hour or so, sip his coffee, and read the paper. So they went in to see him. He had his glasses and his Bible, but he looked over his glasses at him as they introduced themselves and said, "What do you want?" And they said, "Well, we'd like to have about 15 acres of your pasture land down south of the city." He said, "Well, I'll let the farmers graze their cattle there." He says, "I already made a promise to them." That's what he always told him when people went to buy his property. He wanted to keep it. He said, "Wait a second. What did you say your name was?" "Bill Gakers." He goes, "Mr. Yule said, well, you know a grower, Gakers. That's my grandfather. He's the most loyal worker I've ever had. He gave a full day's work for a day's pay. He's the best person I've ever. His integrity and virtue is way up there." He says, "I tell you what, let me think about it. You come back to me in a while." Well, Bill really wanted that property, so about a week later, he goes to see Mr. Yule. Mr. Yule took his glasses off this time and says, when I had the property appraised, I know you wanted that 15 acres, but I appraised it at 3,800. So he's thinking 3,800 an acre, it was almost $60,000. His heart dropped. He knew he could not pay that. Plus a house they would have to build. He's about to say, walk out and say, I can't do it. But Bill said, 3,800. And Mr. Yule says, 3,800 with the 15 acres. Whoa. And so when his children grew up, he's taking a walk with one of them, 12-year-old girl. Says it's a beautiful land that we grew up with, beautiful home, is because of the good name of your grandfather. Because of the good name of your great grandfather. That says something about us. When we keep our promises, we do what is right. Our children, grandchildren will benefit from it. Times we've made mistakes in the past. Lincoln made a mistake in the past. But he went forward, went to politics. We make mistakes, we fail, we're covenant breakers, we don't always do the right thing. But today and going forward is a new time. Let's be promise keepers. Yes, Dad. I'll go. Yes, Pop. I'll go over the field. He never did. Let's do it. Another reason to keep our promises is God made his promise to us. To help us. To create us. To help us. Whatever is needed. Even when we failed him, we ate the apple in the garden, and we sinned. We ate the apple. God said, oh, plan A don't work. I'll come up with plan B. You know, plan B is always the worst than plan A. Not for God. This is what plan B is. Jesus came into the world to save us. God's promise is good. Let's follow him. Make our promises good. Ask the Lord for help. Yes, Paul. I'll go into the vineyard.
Mama. I'm God.
Let's now stand. Confess. Almighty God, whose promises are always good.
that the Lord will show great kindness to the leaders of the church and sustain them in their call to service, especially Pope Francis and Bishop Holly. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That the Lord's guidance will direct our public servants along the path of justice and peace and the promotion of the culture of life and the sanctity of Christian marriage. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That we may be channels of God's love and healing to the poor and needy and those who are suffering in body, mind, or spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For victims of storms, earthquakes, and other natural disasters, victims of violence and persecution, for the first responders, and for all those who minister to them in word and deed, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
That Christ's message of peace will remove the pain of war and violence from human hearts and bring an end to violence and hatred between racial and ethnic groups. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For our military, firefighters, and police who serve to protect us, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For those who have died, those who will die today, and those in purgatory may find everlasting glory in God's salvation. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Lord, we ask you to hear all these prayers, petitions, those that we have not been able to say out loud or on our mind, that you will answer them according to your love for us, Jesus Christ, our Lord.
Amen.
Our presentation is 889 on Eagle's Wings, 889.